How's it going, guys? This is Wyatt here with Planet Binary. So today, I'm going to be walking you guys through upgrading my laptop to a 970 Pro 1TB SSD and installing 32 gigs of RAM from the current 16 that I have in the system. The RAM installation is pretty simple. You just pry out the old chip and slide the new chips in. The SSD installation is a little bit more complicated. So let's take a step back and think about what exactly we're trying to accomplish here. So your current boot drive, the hard drive you have in your computer, has a whole bunch of zeros and ones in it that tell the system how to boot up, all the logic to run the programs that you have in it, all the data that you might have, your personal photos, your essays, whatever you might have for yourself. So we're trying to get that onto the new SSD, the blank SSD that we're upgrading to. So to do that, there's essentially two things that we need. We need an M.2 to USB adapter and a piece of software that will clone the image of the boot drive that we have on our computer to the new SSD. So to copy over our files, there are a few different free softwares out there that can make images of your current drive that you can then put on whatever other drive that you're trying to get it to. But the one that we're going to be using today is called Macrium Reflect 7. It's free to download on their website, but I'll walk you guys through all the steps to download it. Okay, so here we are on the Macrium website. You're going to want to hit Home Use and enter your email address to start the download process. Go ahead and choose whether or not you want their other news. Okay, close out of this window and head over to your email. And follow the link that they sent you to start the download. Just wait for it to finish up here. Go ahead and open up the installer. Okay, choose the free edition where you want to download it and click download. I already downloaded this before I made this video, so I'm just overwriting the install, but it should be the same exact process for you guys. Okay, go ahead and click next. Accept the license. Click home use. Enter your email again and the registration code that they sent you. And get the install going. Okay, so here we are at the Macrium software. You're going to want to click clone this disk. Select a different source disk, select the one that you want to clone, now select the disk that you want to clone to, and then you're going to want to choose all of the drives over. So I started with my C drive, and then you want to go into the cloned partition properties and open up the partition. You want to leave just a small amount of space at the end, though, for the rest of the files that you have to copy over, which are Windows boot files and system restore files and things like that. And it takes a little trial and error. It takes a little bit of trial and error to get just the right amount of space at the end. As you can tell, it took me a few different tries, but you'll get the hang of it. You want to just leave a small amount of free space at the end of the partition. So as you can see, I tried to play with it a little and get it just the right amount, and it took me a few different tries. Okay, still not enough. All right, and there we are. So you're going to want to click next, which will begin the process to clone over your files. So this page just runs down all the different partitions that you want to copy over. But you essentially want everything on the old SSD onto the new one. So you want to click run this now, and it doesn't really matter what you name it. Okay, and now the clone is starting. It should take a bit to finish, so I'm going to go ahead and fast forward through this part, and I will come back to you guys when it is close to being finished. So here we are right at the end of the clone. It's just about done. Okay, and it looks like it copied over. So it booted up as a new F drive. But you should be able to find it under this PC. It should show up for you. Okay, there we are. It took me 17 minutes and 22 seconds. Alright, now that we've got our files copied over to our new SSD, all that's left is to physically install the new RAM and SSD into our laptop. So I'm using a Lenovo Legion Y520, but your laptop is probably pretty similar. Okay, so I skipped through taking the screws off the back of mine for the sake of time. I'll upload another video for you guys of me doing the full removal of the back and the installation of the SSD and memory cards. Okay, so you want to be really careful pulling out the old SSD so as to not bend any of the pins, and you want to carefully slide the new one in. Okay, you want to make sure to gently wiggle the new SSD in and then reattach the screw to hold it in place. Okay, so the RAM is under the silver shield. So you just need to pull back the little black flap there and lift up on the RAM plate. So it feels like it might break, but you have to just wiggle it out. Okay, I'm going ahead and getting the new RAM situated. So the trick to getting the RAM out is to pry the little enclosing pin sideways, and then it will pop up and you can just gently slide the old RAM out. And here I had that first one going in the wrong way. Just had to flip it over and push down and lock it in. and to install the second one. Just make sure it's slotted up correctly. And push it down and lock it in. Okay, and go ahead and put the RAM plate back on. The trick is to just wedge it back in between the enclosing pins. Make sure it's all situated and fold that black flap back over. And go ahead and reinstall all the screws and make sure that the back is connected and everything is back to normal. Okay, so here we are. We are booting it back up. And if everything went as planned, it should boot up straight into the new drive. All right, this looks good so far. And perfect. It looks like it booted up right into Windows 10. And right back to normal. Just how I had it on the SSD before. Okay, and here we are at CPU Z, and you can see that the computer recognizes the increased RAM and the new SSD. And you can go ahead and see the new C drive, and that is the new SSD. All right, and there we are. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you found this video useful and that you were able to do your own RAM or SSD upgrade yourself. And I'll see you next time.